address the conference. At the outset, we should appreciate and congratulate the geospatial world for regularly conducting these conferences on the geo aspects of various regions and technologies. For me itself, I think maybe this is third or so which I am attending, if I am right, regularly, participating in that, and where particularly lots of people from various countries participate. I believe here there are more than about 70-75 people from various countries, probably about 18 or 19 countries attending. And I heard the total registration is about 600 plus. A huge conference. In fact, Honorable Raksha Mantri was feeling bad that he was not able to attend. Out of you know, lots of pressing requirements, particularly yesterday and today. That's how he has sent a video message. Coming to the topic, Indo-Pacific geointelligence, space infrastructure, and geointelligence strategies. Each and every part of it is very, very, very important. When we say Indo-Pacific, it is one which is very, very important in the given scenario, with particularly more than 40 countries in this region, more than about 65% of the population, world population in this Indo-Pacific region, almost about 63% of the world GDP from this region, and almost around about 50% of the merchandise related activities, trade, is from this region. And otherwise also, security-wise, or other aspects-wise, this region is very important. That's how the world has recognized, and there have been multiple collaborations, understandings on this Indo-Pacific region. This is important. And when we look at it, the diversified nature of this whole region, ecosystems, the various nations, with very big economies to small countries, poor economy, the ecosystem is also very diversified, a large maritime region. This calls for a strong collaborative geointelligence. It's very important, the second part of it when it said, the geointelligence strategies. When we say the geointelligence strategies, the firstly fundamentally comes how these so many nations can have a collaborative approach. Why it is? It is extremely difficult, or it is rather too expensive, and to have each and every nation its complete sphere of the geointelligence. It is too much. So, for any nation, it is very clear that we need to have a collaborative approach among the nations, share the data, share the intelligence, and even share the outcomes of that data is very, very important. Leave aside for a while the security aspects of it. I'm talking about economic growth, ecology, disasters, and many other aspects when you look at it. This approach is very, very essential. When we say this approach, the most fundamental element comes in here is building the trust among the nations. The trust becomes the fundamental aspect of it. Unless there is trust among the nations, confidence among the members, and then respect for each other, I think that type of collaboration coming is very, very difficult. say respect, the respect for the IPRs, the respect for the data, the respect for the intelligence, the respect for the utilization of their data, all that should be part and parcel of this trust. And then what we need is later open communication, open data sharing. As I said, as its multi-dimensional aspects are involved in it, both technologically, spatially, or otherwise, so these multiple nations with multiple knowledges and domain awareness, it's very important for these people to exchange these, collaborate and synergize. This is one of the very, very important aspects. Just take the aspects of the ecological aspects or natural disasters related aspects of it itself. It's very important that we exchange the information in real time, that automatically the data is available for the multiple nations to look at in real time. If possible, the processed data, it's not just the raw data, the processed data which is available, it helps the humankind in a big way. Let's take the examples of tsunami related things, or the cyclone related movements, or the talk about various other aspects like talking about ice avalanches and related aspects of it, and where there are these ice mountains are common between multiple nations, and when you are observing them from multiple sites. When I say this, actually one important aspect is when we talk about geointelligence, even though the conference has given emphasis on the space, yes, space is very, very important and plays a dominant role, but all other intelligence are also equally important, which actually give a lot of information and which needs to be taken. So that is why I am saying, when we look at it, these aspects of natural calamities, which we need to observe and, both in long term, short term and instantaneous, the sharing of the information between the countries is very, very important. And also in the given scenario today, when we talk about the geointelligence, which need not be instantaneous, it extends right from maritime to liquor water related aspects, or to the ports today, or talk about rail networks, road networks, and among the nations and all that. All these aspects come into the picture. So when we talk about so many areas, the intelligence coming from multiple sources play an important role. Multiple sources, when I say multiple sensors and multiple nations, play an important role. And that sharing among them with openness, with trust, helps the humankind in a big way. So, in taking this into the background, drawing the strategies, how this can happen, how many nations can be part of it, and how it will be, and what type of commonality required, and who should have what, and how do you complement each other, are the strategies aspects of it, so that the resources are, and with limited resources, we are having the maximum information, and then also we are spending as a whole of the world very minimal to get the maximum information. And specifically, the nations which are not that strong economically, or rather poor, those nations will be actually get benefited a lot in this particular aspect. This is the essence of it. And so, with this in the background, I wish that the nations in this region will be able to sit together and draw the strategies how we can work together. Technologically or otherwise, we should be able to use it. This is one of the important aspects what we need to look at it. And I actually appreciate for bringing this particular point of geointelligence strategies. Then coming to the other aspects, when we say space infrastructure, actually or otherwise space combined with ground and sea-based infrastructure, one is, as I was saying, multiple sensors network, both ground-based, sea-based and space-based data, and integrating all of them is an important aspect of it. So, when we say integrating, the amount of data what is unimaginable amount of data. It's extremely difficult to handle this type of a data unless we have a very clear strategy in assimilating this information and also fusing this information and try to extract the outcomes which are very, very useful, user-friendly, and which becomes very simple for the people. So, before getting into that, the infrastructure and the sensors and all that, this aspect of it, that the ground base, including the all others, whether space or maritime or related or ground base, which are like in data, some processing may happen there itself, and then when you are getting it, when you are fusing that for what you need to have, that is where good amount of concentration to extract the right information, which becomes near real time is important. What I am saying is, collecting this much of a sensor data and then transmitting to the stations and processing this gamut of information data and then extracting the right information what you need for actual actions or purposes is very difficult to have it in near or real time. That's why I am using the word near real time is one aspect. And particularly today, when we have such a large data and when we need to analyze it, definitely the AI getting embedded into it is a must. It is otherwise impossible without artificial intelligence to process this type of data and extract information. There is none. That is one important aspect where again we need to look at very strongly and see that the fusion system and the software, the user friendliness and availability of these over communication channels to the various nations is what needs to be looked at it and seen is one important aspect of it. Then coming to the infrastructure, when we say infrastructure, let's say first we talk about the space-based infrastructure. Generally, the space, utility of the space has become very strong these days, and it has particularly in the last couple of years expanded in a big way. Particularly in the military domain, it has expanded very strongly and becoming the fourth dimension of warfare. Space has become the fourth dimension of warfare. And so, intelligence, surveillance, space-based surveillance, intelligence has become very important. That is why actually I use here the word, we normally use space situational awareness. So here I think in this context we have to say the space-based situational awareness. So what we are using the space for the situational awareness in the geospatial aspect of it. So when we talk about space-based infrastructure, there are multiple aspects which come into it. Simple being a common utility aspect of it, I think General Rana has mentioned, is the navigation. First and foremost important thing is the navigation, and where multiple countries have started using it and seen the availability of it in multiple areas and accuracies of it and for the trafficking, whatnot, all those things is one of the important aspects. I think today that is reasonably good enough for absolutely very clear for the civilian application, absolutely. For the types of accuracies, availability, coverage, whether it is GPS, GeoIntelligence, Indo, so many things are in the Japan system. so many things available in this region. So it is in a reasonably good situation. Only thing is the countries have to see that your countries are upgrading and all. It comes to the military domain, the accuracies, and trying to see that long codes and those aspects is another separate aspect. This is one aspect of it. And probably what is another important is equally in real time, the location, what the ship gets or any object gets, how that is transmitted in real time also is one important aspect. Again, the satellite-based communication, the bandwidth, the data rates and all that coming into the picture, that you are able to track every object in real time. Basically, you all know that the space-based navigation system gives you to the object the location of it. Now, that object location, what it is there, that has to be passed on to the various monitoring centers of it, and that has to be blueprinted. Once this aspect is one thing which is covered, then the space-based, as I said, intelligence generation, which comes into picture, whether it is geostationary or geosynchronous, or from there, MEO or LEO, base imagery is one important aspect which plays in these. Whether what is the type of resolutions, accuracies, and then particularly if you are at left orbit, lower orbits, and then the satellite slant and coverage, what it comes in the particular given region, and so what are the number of satellites, what are the revisit, and then how do you get. This is one of the very important aspects. Particularly when you look at it, when you are trying to see the non-stationary vessels or vehicles or whatever it is, this becomes a very important aspect. Let us just look at the example of military naval applications. I am trying to monitor multiple naval ships, and I need to continuously look at them at mostly from the Earth orbits. Particularly when you look at military purposes, you always look for the various signals also, and so you need to have large number of constellation of satellites which are required to look at it and locate it and provide reasonably good accuracies. When I say large number of constellations, you all know that now today, if I want to locate a particular system which is emitting some signals, I need to have at least about 3 satellites or so, and that becomes a constellation. And so, and that has, let's say, a time of about 40 minutes or 30 minutes on a given region. And so I need to have 24 hours coverage, means so many systems I need to have. That's the problem. So this is what, when I said, I was telling in the beginning also, that it's extremely difficult for a nation to, one nation to investigate so much. So that is why I was so this is one of the important aspects where we are working on the resolutions and the images, what are the types of images, for the IR images, talking about these. And particularly when we talk about the military applications, talking about missiles, firings and things like that, and so you have to get the IR sensing and IR sensing based tracking. This is one of the important aspects which, that's why I said, this first and foremost is imaging, and in the imaging, this aspect comes into picture. When you talk about images, naturally we need to talk about two other important aspects of it is the synthetic aperture radar applications, star applications and hyperspectral applications, which actually are very, very important these days. I'm talking about not just maritime related, it's talking about when we say geointelligence, the whole aspects of it will come into picture. These two particular applications play a very, very important role, which actually the world is continuously working to improve the resolutions in these things. Particularly today, hyperspectral, when we are talking about the, one is of course the data and all that, and trying to have the algorithms in one aspect, and second thing is trying to improve the resolutions that you are able to have your surveillance or detection capabilities are much, much, much better. This is one thing actually the world, everyone is trying to invest and trying to see that the technologies are improved a lot in this particular. Other things becomes most important. These are all actually we say dominantly applications are the military applications, other things also come into actually intuitive civil domain also. Is the capabilities for signal intelligence or communication intelligence or for the electronic intelligence. These actually, particularly in the LN, the world has moved in a big way. Particularly, mostly it is for military applications where the sensitivity of the systems, the location accuracies are dominantly by many countries have been improving it and trying to see that the sensitivities are going much better every day, getting to the figures of almost 120 dBm and all that is one of the important aspects which is coming into in that aspect. And trying to see that location accuracies we are getting into where kilometers are coming to meters. That is one of the important technologies improvement what has happened in these days. In the series when we are talking about leaving aside the intelligence aspect of it, the communication. The space-based communication is an important thing which has come up in a big way. I feel still it is evolving itself in a big way. I strongly feel that in the coming years, maybe about 4 years, 5 years down the line, the space-based or utilizing the space, the communication system is going to be changing a lot in it. Particularly with satellites, multiple satellites, a constellation of large number of satellites in the low Earth orbit or very low Earth orbits is going to change the communication in the world in a big way. I don't think that today's scenario of that there are regions where you have dark regions or gray areas where communication is not available, deal with the situation of something. You will be having space-based hubs. The hubs from ground will be transferred to the space and you will be having that type of a technology. And I think particularly with the private industry getting into the space domain in a big way, and the space-based economy is also, a business is also changing every day, evolving itself in a big way. Lots of private industries which are coming out with lots of ideas. I'm continuously talking about this particular aspect of communication, providing the communication, trying to have as small as possible terminals and you are able to continuously interact, continuously have, and then trying to see the bandwidths are very high, data rates are very high, is one way. A lot of work is going on in R&D organizations and also in the private institutions in a big way, including our country in a big way. So there are lots of startups which are working on this. That is why I am saying that 4 years down the line, 3 years down the line, there will be a sea change in this, which actually helps the humankind. As I said, in all aspects, including the natural disasters and environment-related, weather-related aspects also, which actually helps the humankind in a big way. One is sensing, second thing is the communication. These two are equally important, not just sensing and then you are not able to communicate, you are not able to transmit the data and then huge amount of data, you are not able to process it. See, there are actually, I see that in all the Himalayan regions, you may have a weather station. The weather station, what it is sensing, is it able to pass the data to the actually the army command or whatever it is in a quick time, fast time, or in real time is what is important. So, sensing, processing, and then communicating becomes the very, very important. So, these are all the top level technological areas of space infrastructure, matched, combined, fused with the ground-based and sea-based. So let's say just we talk about the sea-based and I'm talking about it today. Anti-submarine warfare is a very important aspect for any military domain. So how do we actually look at it? How do we locate a submarine and very successful? Space-based, or it is ship-based, or your own sonobuoys and related waste is one thing. I strongly feel that it is a fusion of all this data, all the sensors data to be available, which need to be continuously fused and maybe sometimes one plays a dominant role, the other plays a lower significant role based on the type of environment and from where you are looking at it, what the type of data is one of the very important aspects. So all the sensors play, and including the coastal surveys, radars and all that, what we have, the coastal and the port and everything, plays a major important role, both in the civilian domain and military domain. So this, looking at all these angles, this conference, the themes are very, very important for all the nations. And so the last aspect of drawing strategies and looking at the technologies plays a major role. I very, very honestly appreciate the geospatial world for taking this theme and having this conference. And I'm very happy that so many people from so many countries have attended, and a large number from this country. I wish the conference a great success. I wish that on each and every theme, the conference will be deliberating in depth, looking at various aspects, come out with clear outcomes, and then which becomes input to various nations, and which can be submitted to the various agencies and departments which are concerned with this, and which can be taken forward, and which becomes important input for the next conference also.